Hi, bro. This is Home Thin Man back in another video. Today, I just want to talk. I'm sorry I haven't made a video in a while. I'm just feeling down and stuff because of everything that happened with my family. Long story, my dad passed away. I'll try to start pumping out more content for you guys here shortly. But, anyways, just bear with me. And I want to show you guys, I got a good perfect image. Now what I realized, I did some tests with my TV, QN90C TV, and I figured, because, like, here's the thing, anytime you brighten your picture on your TV, it's going to show more and more grain on it. As the brighter the picture, more grain the TV's going to show. That's what I realized. I'm going to show you guys this, my settings here, on my QN90C. My mom's listening to stories upstairs, that's funny. You know it. I'm gonna show you guys my picture settings here. One thing, I am in filmmaker mode. Export settings, I got brightness on 50. Contrast on 50. You want sharpness on 0, because anytime, some people will tell you to bump it to 12. You do not want it bumped up, you don't want any sharpness, because what's gonna do, you add sharpness to the picture, it is going to make the picture all blurry eventually. It's going to make the picture a little bit blurry. It's not going to be as clear, guys. Color 25. And I'm saying, for HDR, when you're watching high dynamic range, you want the brightness on 50 for your TV setting. I apply current source. Picture clarity setting, you want this turned off. You could set an auto if you wanted to, but you just want it off. The best accurate picture. Here's where I find out the best picture, guys. Level dim, I keep it high. On contrast enhanced, I keep off. This is what made a big difference to me. I feel like I could probably go ahead. Yeah, that's better. Got the answer on this. Actually, standard is the way to go, guys. If you want more of a better picture, standard is the way to go. And, it's high is, so it's actually not my fault. So, standard is going to be more blown out, I guess. It's going to make it more brighter, a little bit more brighter. Don't know why this is. If you guys know why this is, leave a comment down below. If you own a Samsung QN90C TV, when I type in local dim on high, it seems like the local dim on high gives a better accurate picture than on standard. If you guys look on standard, let me zoom in for you guys here. You guys can see his shirt get washed out as soon as you shadow on the shirt. You see a shadow on the shirt as soon as you see it brightens the picture up. Isn't that weird? So, I don't know, I think high is probably, I'm just going to do, low is too dark, I think standard is probably the way to go. If you noticed, to the right, guys, picture looks washed out when you go to standard, looks better. Picture looks better. Your standard, the picture gets washed out in the corner there. You can see it washed out in the corner. Like, see it? See what I'm doing? Standard washed out. It's washed out on that corner there on the left. The standard looks more natural. When I go to high, it looks more natural. Not real, guys. Contrast hands, okay. I find out when you leave contrast and hands on, you are going to blow out the picture. Even if you lower it on low, you still gonna get, it's gonna show a lot of grain, guys. Contrast enhancer will show grain, I noticed. So just need, contrast enhancer, it brightens the picture way higher than it needs to be. Go high, it's even brighter. I don't like that, guys. I actually like it off. It looks a lot better off. Contrast enhancer. Now, HDR tone, I keep that active. When I keep contrast enhanced off, I like still like a bright enough picture. So I'm gonna keep on active. If you guys notice, I'm gonna keep on static. It's gonna be a lot darker. So see, I actually like it active, guys. Sacks the way to go, guys, in this picture. But I like active. It's just static. If you want filmmaker creator's intent, static is the way to go, guys. If you want creator's intent, static is the way to go. You want to just watch a movie or it's a little bit bright picture, leave it active. I think active looks perfectly fine to me. I like a little bit of brightness in my picture. I don't want my picture too dark. I think active is the way to go. I'll keep it 1-1. I think 1-2 looks, I don't know, let me ask, is 1-1, please leave a comment down below, is 1-1 more accurate for the picture quality setting on the Q90C, or is it 1-2? I think 1-2 adds too much color to it. It adds too much color to it, guys. I don't like 1-2. It adds too much yellow to the picture, and I don't like that. I want it to be more of a natural picture, which I like 1-1, I think, will be best for me. That BT2084 for HDR. Color space got native. That's what we want. So that's about it, guys. My settings for my TV picture. I think it looks beautiful. I'll show you a quick demo, guys, of the movie. Oh, one thing I want to tell you guys as well, show you guys as well. We're just gonna go into all settings, okay? Then we're gonna go down. I want to turn off. I want to turn off settings. That's totally makes it too blue. Target mode. Let's just see something here. See, some people say on this, when you leave intelligent mode off, it makes the picture look blue. We're just going to do a quick demo here, guys. Hold on a second. Okay, guys, here's a quick setting I want to try real quick here. I want to see what intelligent mode does on this picture, guys. It blows it up and it makes it blue. Some people say it makes the picture look blue, really blue on the TV. But to me, intelligent mode is on my Q90C. Does not make the picture look blue. It does not add a blue light filter on it. Which we'll test some out here, guys. Okay. Let's just get close here. Let's see the difference. See, when I leave intelligent mode on, it doesn't do any difference other than it makes the picture a lot more clearer. When I leave intelligent mode on, it makes the picture look more clearer and cleaner when I leave intelligent mode on the TV. However, that's the picture you want to be off. That picture you want off, because that's when it'll adjust your brightness and cut all your settings on this. You want that to be off, guys. Eye comfort. I don't like eye comfort, guys. I'm gonna leave that off. Eye comfort, I'm gonna leave it off. Let's see what optimize this. So I don't like optimize. I don't like that. I want that to be off. Yeah, the picture looks a lot better now. So I think intelligent mode makes the picture look more clear when you leave it on. Just my opinion. Leave intelligent mode on, guys. It helps with the cleanness of the picture. Makes it look more cleaner and clearer and more vibrant. Just want to show you guys that here. Let's just do a quick demo for you guys. Again, I do have contrast enhancer off on my TV. I think the picture looks gorgeous right now. This is what it should look, guys. It looks more, a lot really accurate. It looks beautiful. Just take a look at this, guys. Well, I think it looks beautiful, the picture quality. The way it is now, I'm happy with the picture quality. It looks stunning, beautiful. And then shines. I'm just trying to show you guys this picture quality. I hope you guys like and subscribe to my channel. Leave a comment down below of what your thoughts are. Let me know you guys' thoughts on this. Let's see if we can reach 500 subscribers before the end of the month. I'll try to push out more content. Have a good day, guys. Take care. Bye.